When I think of the history of the department, I'm struck by the fact that not only has it risen to a very high level of quality, but it stayed at a high level of quality through many generations. And I think that has been because it's always worried about the future. It's always been careful to plan for the future, and that makes me very hopeful that the next 100 years are going to see a continuation of what has been a great record.
CMS has a long legacy of leading the fields of chemical engineering and materials science, and it does this by continuing to reinvent itself. The current cadre of faculty and students really represents the next generation.
It's just a really vibrant intellectual community, a place to come to work every day with colleagues and students that are really engaged in cutting-edge research of their own, but also really committed to crossing boundaries of disciplines and working together.
We have world-class scientists and experts in their respective fields, but they also go out of their way to collaborate with other departments, both inside the University of Minnesota and outside, to come up with something greater than what they could do by themselves.
I think one of the biggest things is we have an incredible reputation, and so when that means when we go to conferences, when I'm meeting other faculty from other institutions, people know us, people are aware of our work, people get excited of our work.
I see the department engaging in today's most pressing problems on a larger scale than they have ever been before. They'll be involved with outreach, they'll be opening their doors to including wider populations and getting people's heads together to really figure out the root cause of some of the issues we face today.
Well, I believe there's just so much to do in the world. I look at climate change, I look at the number of people that are being born and all the challenges that are coming in the future to feed them and do all the other things we need to do. So I believe that this group can really add value in the future.
I think CEMS is going to be the breeding ground of new technologies for solving the problems of climate change, separation and purification technologies for cleaner air and water, and solving the problem of ocean plastic.
I see it changing by accepting more women, or making just more open to a variety of backgrounds. Being able to help somebody else like they helped me is the least I can do to help the department and to help the profession.
An important thing that the department has always stood for is excellence, but it combines that with accessibility. We're a large department. We educate hundreds of engineers, material scientists every year, and that breadth and accessibility to qualified students is a singularly important feature of the department and has to be maintained.
We should be investing in this education, and especially the technical education, because that essentially is where a successful career is built, and that's where a successful life is built.
We're trying to teach students not only some facts about chemistry and engineering, how to put things together and solve problems, but how to be innovative, how to work in teams, and how to be a leader. And if our department keeps going in that future of creating the whole student, we're going to be outstanding for the next 100 years, and I want to be a part of that.